Assalamu alaikum and hello and welcome to Baby Step Med, where I try and make difficult medical concepts a bit easier. In this video, I'm going to be talking about the embryology of the heart, and it's kind of confusing, but I hope that this video makes things easier for you. So we're going to start off with the cardiogenic area, okay? And so, how is the cardiogenic area formed? So basically, at the mid of the third week, the vascular system appears, okay? And you have progenitor cells, okay? What are progenitor cells? From which other types of cells are formed. They are in the epiblast at the cranial end of the primitive streak, okay? So these progenitor cells, they're going to migrate to the splanchic layer of the lateral plate mesoderm, okay? And here, they form like this heart, this horseshoe cluster of cells, okay? So like, what does a horseshoe look like? Looks like a U. So that's what's happening. And this horseshoe cluster, we call this the primary heart field, okay? And this is formed at day 16 to 18, okay? Now, you have cells, and they're specified on both sides, okay? So we have the primary heart field, and we have cells specified on both sides, the left and right cells. The left and right sides, they form the atria, left ventricle, and most of the right ventricle. And the rest of the heart and the outflow tract is derived from the secondary heart field. Okay. And this happens at about like day 20 to 21. And where does the secondary heart field lie? It lies in the splanchic mesoderm and the ventral aspect of the posterior pharynx. Okay. And now the secondary heart field cells, they show laterality, okay? And so basically it's opposite. So the right side forms the left outflow region and the left side forms the right outflow region, okay? And this explains the spiraling nature of the aorta and pulmonary artery, because they're like from opposite sides. And this ensures that they exit from the right ventricle and the left ventricle in the heart that we now know, okay? So, okay, now the cells, okay, they are induced by the pharyngeal endoderm, okay, and they form two things. They form the cardiac myoblast. So as you can see, I've made like a heart with like, it's like flexing. So it's just like muscles, so cardiac myoblasts and blood islands, okay. And the blood islands, they form together and they form the blood vessels, the blood cells and blood vessels by vasculogenesis, okay? And the blood cells unite and form a horseshoe-shaped endothelial line. So as you can see, we have a horseshoe shape, and it's lined by endothelium in the blue, and it is surrounded by myoblasts, which were formed from here. And we call this area the cardiogenic area, okay? This area. And some of the blood islands, they appear bilaterally, parallel, or close to the midline of the embryonic shield, and they form a pair of longitudinal vessels called the dorsal aorta. Okay, now what about the cardiogenic area? The cardiogenic area, it has the intraembryonic cavity over it, so it's surrounded by an intraembryonic cavity. It forms the pericardial cavity, okay, and that cavity, okay, and that is what the primary heart field is. Now we have the formation of the heart tube. So as the embryo grows, it bends cephalocaudally, so from the head towards the bottom, and it folds laterally, okay, and you have this tube thingy, right? A tube is formed, which is open on the one end. So the caudal regions merge, so that is the closed end, and the central part, one end remains open, okay? And the central part, is this in focus? Okay. And the central part of that heart tube region, it expands to form the future outflow tract and the ventricular areas, okay? And now your myocardium, as you saw the drawing with the myoblast, it thickens. And now your tube has three layers, okay? The endocardium, the myocardium, and the epicardium, okay? So the endocardium forms the internal lining, and it is formed by the angioblastic mesoderm. The myocardium is a muscular wall, and it is formed by the splanchic mesoderm. And the epicardium is the outside of the tube, and it is formed by the mesothelial layer of the mesoderm. And the epithelial, the epicardium forms the coronary arteries and their endothelial lining and smooth muscle. We have dilatations happening. Okay, so there are a total of 5 dilatations which appear along the length of the tube, and the mnemonic, it's not really a mnemonic, it's just a phrase, it's TBPPS. Okay, so we have the truncus arteriosus, bulbous cordis, primitive ventricle, primitive atrium, and sinus venosus. And I have a drawing right here to show you it. And so this is TBPPS. Okay, and I'm going to get back to this in just like a minute. Then we have looping, okay? So cells from the secondary heart field are added to the heart tube, okay? And this is regulated by the neural crest cells, okay? And this lengthens and elongates the tube because you're adding in more cells. And this is essential for the proper formation of the right ventricle and the outflow region, okay? And then this bends, okay? And a cardiac loop is created, okay? And the cephalic end bends towards the right and the caudal end bends towards the left, okay? And this cardiac loop is created by day 28 and the heart tube bends at about day 23, okay? If this doesn't happen, if it doesn't lengthen or elongate, we have your congenital heart anomalies, like the tetralogy of flow and stuff like that, okay, and ventricular septal defects and all of that stuff, okay. And when the loop is created, you have some local expansions seen through it. So now what about these dilatations? Okay, so TBPS. You have your truncus arteriosus forms the aorta and pulmonary artery. Your primitive atrium forms the atria. Conus cordis, not shown here, it forms the outflow tracts of the ventricles. The bulbous cordis forms the right ventricle. And I just like use like very lame a mnemonic. You use your right ventricle to scream out, "I choose you, Bulbasaur." Because, you know, I don't know. Use your right hand to throw the Pokeball. I don't know. It's like, if this helps stick it this into your mind, then great. Otherwise, just ignore what I just said. So these are your dilatations.